I want to take a moment to talk about a column that was printed in the Wall Street Journal over the weekend that garnered a lot
oh
of attention.
God. Holy cow.
And it got all this attention for all the wrong reasons. Maybe they were looking for clickbait. I don't know. It was very lowbrow. The Journal's editorial page published an op-ed by columnist Joseph Epstein that begins this way, quote, Madam First Lady, Mrs. Biden, Jill, kiddo.
Kiddo.
A bit of advice on what may seem like a small, but I think is a not unimportant matter. Any chance you might drop the doctor before your name, Dr. Jill Biden? Sounds and feels fraudulent, not to say a touch comic. And the column is pretty much downhill from there. If you can imagine, he was dead serious when he wrote that. The piece hit quite a dubious trifecta. An attack on Jill Biden's doctorate that managed to be petty, elitist, and misogynistic all at once.
Triple crown winner there.
And to a highly accomplished 69-year-old woman was to tell the kiddo who received two masters as well as a doctorate that she shouldn't use the term doctor unless she delivered a baby. Questioning what planet we're on at this point as I'm reading it. We don't even have to ask if this would have been written about a man.
Well, it never is.
My God.
Actually.
I mean, it's thank you. Yeah,
it just never is. You actually have somebody that you've loved in your life who, I don't know, people have called a doctor for decades. Nobody ever called Dr. Brzezinski a kiddo.
You see, Epstein's standard, which the Wall Street Journal gave voice to, defies the Journal's own standards. The paper's opinion page described Henry Kissinger as such in 2014. Quote, Dr. Kissinger served as National Security Advisor.
Did he deliver babies?
He must be so
Dr. Kissinger's an OB? Really?
Yeah.
I never knew that side of Dr. Kissinger.
Earlier this year, the Wall Street Journal quoted a conversation the president-elect had with my father when Biden was in the Senate. Quote, Doctor, we should have you here more often.
Doctor,
I appreciate
your
taking the time. We have two distinguished panelists to follow. We're going to recess to go for vote again. Dr. Brzezinski.
Doctor.
It's always a pleasure to have you here. I always learn something when you're here. Dr. Brzezinski. No one there seemed to have a problem with that.
Isn't it? Wait, hold on. So Dr. Brzezinski, they got no problem with that. Dr. Kissinger, they got no problem with that.
No.
But Dr. Biden, how are they different? Hold on, you keep going. I'm going to think about this.
She cares about community college students getting to where they want to go.
She's a woman, actually.
Okay.
Kiddo.
So, like the Wall Street Journal and the president-elect, the New York Times has always been comfortable using the honorific doctor in news stories, like the one reporting on William F. Buckley's funeral. Quote, Dr. Kissinger's gravelly voice. Choked with emotion several times. And the Washington Post obit piece upon my father's passing did as well. Dr. Brzezinski was a captivating lecturer at Harvard and then at Columbia. He was a teacher, too.
Tell me, did your father deliver you?
Nope.
Did he ever deliver any babies?
He did not deliver a baby.
Wow.
And I'm fairly certain that Kissinger didn't deliver a baby either.
Probably not.
Now, this writer Epstein may not take issue with my father and Henry Kissinger being called doctor because, well, they earned their degrees back in the good old days. The columnist dismisses Dr. Biden's academic feat because she only acquired hers 15 years ago, long after the days when, as he describes in this piece, a secretary sat outside the room where these examinations were administered.
The women were on the outside.
A pitcher of water and a glass on her desk. The water and glass were there for the candidates who fainted. And, of course, note the gender he assigns to the secretary. So let's just be clear about the true worth of Dr. Biden's title, one she earned at the age of 55 when she returned to school to get her doctoral degree, because she never gave up on her career and her dreams, no matter what, even after raising children and continuing to support her husband's career as well. Dr. Biden is an educator who chose to teach even during the 8 years that she served as Second Lady of the United States. In fact, she continued teaching when her husband was running for the Senate, for the vice presidency, and for the presidency. She would fly to Iowa and fly back and make it to class. I know Jill Biden well. She's always wanted her staff members to call her Jill. They call her Dr. Biden out of respect for a highly accomplished woman who deserves much more than the condescending column that the Wall Street Journal stooped to publish this weekend. This is a woman who knows her value, and with her in the White House, she will help so many others do the same. For more on Dr. Jill Biden, go to knowyourvalue.com. And as for the Wall Street Journal, you owe the future First Lady an apology. We'll be right back.
Thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube. And make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.